How's everybody today?
Good.
How many presents do you think there is tonight for the crowd? No. I cut some of you out. I think there's 170, actually. So you have a pretty good chance. And standard process and biotics and everybody has donated generously, so that's kind of nice. It's hard to believe today at this next lecture that there's any other cause of heart disease than a Lipitor deficiency. I want you to notice that's April 13th. April 13th. It's not the first Wednesday. It's General Motors has this entire, I believe, building that day. So it's going to be the second Wednesday. That throws the whole thing off. So just if you come here the first Wednesday, you'll be entertaining yourself. Mr. Spangler will be here to entertain you. Dr. Jeff, who a lot of you have talked to, because when you call, I don't want to talk to you. Jeff talks to you. So Dr. Jeff has a great lecture scheduled January 26th. I'm sure he'll do a great job. He puts a lot of time and energy into this, so he works pretty hard at it. Number two, next. And Dr. Jeff has put together a newsletter, actually. So you can look for this. I'm not as tech savvy as the young people are, and that's how you can find it, and you'll kind of enjoy that. And we're going to have some of our handouts and stuff on that. Try to cut down on all the stuff in our files, which is an awful lot. At the last lecture, Dylan, you were gone. You were out of town that time, weren't you? So one of my son's close friends, his name is Jack, his dad dropped dead working out at the gym. It was one of those Bob Probert deaths. He just dropped dead in a pile in the corner. He was an anesthetist for 35 years. He spent his whole life in the hospital. His wife is a nurse. So together they had, I'm sure, 60, 70 years in the hospital. They have all, no man has survived past 60. So my wife said to me, why don't you bring that clotting panel home and give it to Dylan. Dylan, raise your hand. There's my son. He'll give it to Jack and tell Jack to have his mother run this test on him. So I sent that. This will be covered in detail at the next lecture. And I sent it home with him. So his family was told, and they all work in the hospital, they were told they were cursed. I said, what do you think this is? He said, we were told it's a family curse. You're cursed. So I ran this test on him, and he came over on a Friday, and he said, Mr. Tent, the test came back, and it's normal. There's nothing wrong. I said, Jack, after 30 years of doing this, I don't believe anything they say. I don't believe anything they say. I said, I want to see the paperwork. So the next day he came over and brought the paperwork. Here is his official paperwork. And his whole family has dropped dead from homocysteine. This is an 18-year-old kid. There's the level under abnormal, completely out of range. And at the bottom, Carolyn, I saved her some dignity by crossing off her last name. Wrote perfect at the bottom. Perfect. And so everybody in my family looked at this and said, how did she miss this? So every man is dead before 60. They all can't metabolize homocysteine. He's 18. I told him some simple suggestions that I wanted him to do every other month. And you guys aren't going to croak till you're 40 or above. Then you can start doing it every month. And you should be able to live to 90. So this is the official paperwork of the official doctor that took care of them for 60, 70 years. So he came to my office. I let him read that clotting panel board. How many people in this crowd have read that board, my clotting panel board? You can look around and see some hands. He noticed a kid that had 90 brain surgeries. There's a young man named Tim. He's had hydrocephalus. He's got a shunt in his head, and the shunt plugged up 90 times. So he had nine, and he read that story and went, tell me this story, because it was homocysteine underneath. And I asked him, Lou's going to hit you. Lou, the Muslim Brotherhood. He's got connections to the old country. Where was I? Okay, so I walked into this mom and this 21-year-old kid. He's with 90. They had to drill the shunt out 90 times in his head. And I looked at mom and son, and I said, is your husband still alive? She said, no. I said, how old was he when he died? She said, 38. I said, what did he die of? She said, a heart attack. I said, that's the same thing, plugging up the shunt in his head. And he tested positive for the same thing. You know what your brain looks like after 90 surgeries? Mush. And this kid looked at me and said, you know, growing up in a medical family, he was at my office on a, we came up here on a Saturday, kind of let him read the board, explain what he had to do. He said, you know, you've changed my entire opinion of medicine in this half hour. He said, how come nobody knows about this? I said, there's no pharmaceuticals for this, Jack. They've decided to sacrifice millions of people for something that there's no drug for. So they just ignore it. And he's completely disgusted with no males alive in his family, and they all worked in a hospital. And that's Jack's official paperwork. And that's normal, by the way. How come October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, not Breast Cancer Prevention Month? Did anybody participate in this and not wonder why is this not about prevention?
There's no drug.
So I just thought that was interesting. I would hope, I have been hit up many times. Now, I'm going to tell you something. The line, you folks are going to have to find out where the line in the sand is and draw it, because you're being sold down the river every day. And you'll be, I think you'll agree, when this is over, you'll realize that when they try to, all these little happy kids come up to me, would you like, I'm going to run in circles for raising money for breast cancer. And I have to look into their sweet little eyes and say, no. I've had them get weepy in front of me because everybody fell for that little smile except for me. Mm. I don't buy Shamrocks for muscular dystrophy. That was cured 60 years ago. Next time you're at the vet, I want you to ask your vet, do you have muscular dystrophy in animals? And he will laugh at you. And he'll tell you, we cured that 60 years ago by putting minerals in their food. That's why it's hard to find fish with cancer in the ocean, because the minerals kept them healthier than the fish in the lakes. That's the secret. Yesterday, the Senate passed. How many people heard about this Senate bill that passed yesterday? Raise your hand.
No more gardens.
No more gardens. You can't grow a cucumber. You cannot have a backyard garden. It would grant the U.S. government's new authority over the public rights to grow, trade, and transport any foods. This would give Big Brother the power to regulate the tomato plants in your backyard. It would grant them the power to arrest and imprison people selling cucumbers at farmers' markets. This tyrannical law puts all food production, yes, even food produced in your own garden, under the authority of the Department of Homeland Security. This passed yesterday. Now where does it have to go? To the House. Now, the kids are worried about their Game Boys and their minimum wage jobs. You retirees better, you're the only ones that can name who your representatives are. The kids don't know. You better be making some phone calls. Because the things that are going on and on and on, it's changing weekly. It's changing weekly. It doesn't take years to change. It's changing by the week. This passed yesterday. And you watch this little lame duck section of Congress, they're going to make you pay for voting them out of office. They're going to make you pay. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Oh. You want to know why we're broke? Do you want to know why we're broke? Do you really want to know why we're broke? The feds spent $800,000 of our economic stimulus on African genital washing program. The National Institutes of Health, a division of the National Institutes of Health, of course, of mental health, I can't see that, spent $823,000 of economic stimulus funds in 2009 on a study by a UCLA research team to teach uncircumcised African men how to wash their genitals after having sex. You know.
Is that our money?
You know, I want to talk to my African American brothers here, the men. Does this not have whitey written all over it? Run. If anybody says we're going to help you wash your thing, run. Trump, I was reading an article about Trump wanting to run for president, and they asked him why. He said, all they do, I work internationally. We are the laughing stock of the world. He said, all they do, he said, when I go to China, they laugh at us. They just laugh at this. We're the laughing stock of the world as we go broke. I told my nurses, I have three nurses at Carmanos walking around with masks on that are patients. They signaled them out for not getting the flu shot. So they have to walk around with a mask on when they're within 6 feet of people. And they wanted you to wear a little yellow marker to designate these people as the unwashed. And I told my nurses to take, hopefully Jeff can put all these things up on the lecture. Next. The ADA, the dentist came out since the last 2 weeks, and the CDC and admitted, we have to admit to you that fluoride is ruining your teeth. And they officially admitted that. And I will guarantee you, the dentist will give you fluoride treatments tomorrow. Your toothpaste is saturated with it. As I said, take this with you to work and ask them, when are they going to find out that all this mercury was a problem too? How many people will be left? But this is how bad. Was this in the paper? This wasn't actually in the paper. And last Friday, the Free Press, which would never lie to you, never, said, there's no flu this season. There's like the flu like disappeared. They don't know where it is. There isn't any. So the fear that was supposed to be there is gone. Next. If I had teeth left, this is the pill you'd take if you had teeth left.
By itself?
By itself. If you have roots in your mouth, the amount of money that I blew to get my teeth jerked out from all the fluoride treatments, all the mercury, all the stuff that I went through, and it basically all happened because my father had very good insurance. And I paid dearly with my teeth for that good insurance. It cost me all of them. So when I watch these feet people getting clipped $1,500 a root canal, when I had my teeth jerked out of my 15 root canals, five of them were chronically abscessed. I'd have pulled them all out a second time, despite the mess they made of my mouth, because you do not want to live with your mouth aching long. And so I went through all the steps you were supposed to do, and if I could start over, I could have saved a fortune. Dylan, you try to get my son there to drill on his tooth, because he'll go home. And he's grown, how many cavities in your mouth have you grown out?
I don't know.
He'll take he will stop the dentist if he gets his teeth clean and come back and grow the cavities out taking that. And Amy did the same thing when she was pregnant. Amy grew three of them out of her teeth when she was pregnant. Dentin is raw tooth. I watched Bill Gates, it was yesterday night. Anybody see Buffett and Gates on that China show? Anybody watch that? Of course you didn't. What do you do when you're a billionaire? How do you spend your time when you're worth $1 billion?
Let's take a look. First, we've got population. The world today has 6.8 billion people. That's headed up to about 9 billion. Now, if we do a really great job on new vaccines, healthcare, reproductive health services, we could lower that by perhaps 10 or 15%.
Is there anything wrong with that picture? Yeah, he didn't lie to you. He told you the truth. Did it register that what he actually said? Anybody register?
Yeah.
Okay.
If you get good medical care, you have a better chance of dying.
So with vaccinations, reproductive services and healthcare, government healthcare, they'll lower the population. And he'll tell you that. I know. Next. There's two presents. Your winter, there's some strange things going on. And there's going to be a line crossed in this country that's going to start more chaos than the lines crossed. You have a homework project for the next lecture. Lou is in charge of it. There's two prizes that are going to be worth something. If you can answer two questions, what line is going to be crossed that will not be tolerated by the big guy in the United States. Very simple. Your homework project, there'll be two determined presence at the next lecture, and Lou's going to be in charge of this. I think you'll find this amazingly interesting. Next. The companies have graciously donated 12 of each of those. Yesterday in the paper, the Institute of Medicine said they set the upper limits of vitamin D at 600 units. 600 units. They finally came. Five drops of those a day is a lifeguard dose. I have lots of people on 4 to 5 drops. That's the pill form. Next. David Williams in his newsletters will put a 2-year-old on 1,000 international units. So they have had to reset all these vitamin D levels. And they said, after telling you to stay out of the sun for 50 years, that if you got enough vitamin D in your system, 77% of all cancers would not be there. 77% of all cancers would have never manifested just from vitamin D. So in the times that you've been listening to me here, vitamin D has become the most critical vitamin in cancer prevention. 70, that's huge. But you know how many times I've heard, I have to stay out of the sun, doctor. This is Michigan, there is no sun. Get in the sun, get in the sun. Who spends a day in the sun and feels worse? Nobody, and still everybody avoided the sun. This doesn't even bother saying anything about, because it's a lost cause. They'll ache, their heart starts to beat funny, their eyes are glassed over, they're getting weak, they can't climb stairs anymore, they can't chop wood. 900 studies in the American Journal of Cardiology. Muscle problems, brain problems, pain or numbness, heart failure. Next, I have to make sure that reference is up there so they don't shoot me. The American Journal of Cardiovascular Drugs, 900 studies. They've got people thinking that this is more important than a vitamin that they could be taking. This has become a religion to the people. They claim cholesterol medication and acid-blocking supplements, or drugs, Nexium, Prilosec, Pepcid. They say those two classes of drugs could bankrupt Medicare by themselves. Just those two. So I try to. So the people in the waiting room, because I know you're all too smart to do that, that's what you want to take to try to rebuild the vitality that's been sucked out of your cells. I enjoy that pill. I am much stronger on an ATP modulator. I've talked about that before, so I'm not going to belabor the point. I enjoy feeling sturdy at this job because you would not believe the dysfunction I have to put up with every day. How many people work with the public? Right? If you work with the public, not say that, raise your hand. Can I hear an amen from anybody that works with the public? Amen. They're nuts. They're completely nuts. Zoo. And if you don't, you don't understand it. And I'll tell that to anybody that doesn't work with the public. They're nuts. The TV has trained them well. The drug industry, they found and published in the Annals of Internal Medicine, every time they fund a drug company test, it always shows a positive result. They never have bad results. It's just some kind of fluke thing that I don't know how this happens, but it's always positive. You know how many hours I have also spent trying to convince parents that their kid's fine? Your kid's fine. Your kid's fine. But he's in kindergarten. He's got ADD. Well, everybody does in kindergarten. Who wants to? I don't want to be here in the first place. They took me from my mommy. They just found out, oh my gosh, we must have misdiagnosed a million people. Because we just, when they looked at the studies, they went, son of a gun, it is the youngest kid in the class. It is, did we misread this or what? They really now, you know how many kids are on medication? You know how many billions have spent because they're the youngest kid in the class? Amazing. How many people know somebody personally that's lost their mind? Raise your hand. All those drugs shut off acetylcholine. They're anticholinergics. They block acetylcholine. It's kind of interesting. So, and when you study this, you'll find out that they help generate a state of unconsciousness while you're awake. They're going to make you unconscious while you're awake. There's something that I would encourage all my patients to have. Is there 12 of these in the bags? There's 12 of these in the bags. Everything. There's nothing on that list. Don't spray this one on until after you go through the TSA. I want you to wait till you get on the plane, pull out your little bottle. We might as well share with our Homeland Security people. But I want to show you what makes this. This is, people have been making this little combination up for years. I'll show you a very cool combination that works on a ton of skin things. A ton. It's silver, vitamin D, and potassium iodide. That's the pill that they gave the Polish children when Chernobyl exploded. This is a great spray to put on all kinds of things. You can spray it on or in anything. Isn't it funny? I'm sitting at lunch reading the USA Today. And they wanted to apologize to the Guatemalans because apparently we gave them syphilis and gonorrhea. We sent U.S. Public Health Service doctors and they injected the Guatemalan patients with syphilis and gonorrhea without their knowledge to study what venereal disease actually looked like. So we sent one of the bastions of ethical behavior, Hillary Clinton. I'm sure Hillary has a lot to know about ethics and aberrant behavior. It's familial over there. So I thought, what an interesting thing. And you know, I was thinking, thank goodness that they don't experiment on us anymore. I feel very happy to know that there's no way that they're going to ever do anything like that again. So I'm happy now that we have a more ethical administration, or the past few administrations. I haven't even watched this with my parents. This is the latest, hottest thing out on the internet before it's gone. This is, you know, the Christmas project. You want a YouTube. What in the world are they spraying? It's how many people in this crowd have watched it? So you want to go home. You've got to watch it in little pieces on YouTube. And you're going to have to take your immune system and things very seriously. You're going to have to, health should be your primary issue today, because if they can get their paws in it enough, and you have to go to the medical community, you're not going to like the hoops that you have to jump through. The mandatory shots, they forced the nurses under their jobs this year to get shots. How many people heard that? I mean, you had to. You're going to lose your job. I talked to some patients about getting around that and what I personally would do. But this is getting very seriously. That's very serious. This is not going to be fun. I don't have any health insurance, so I'm going to maybe just sign up for Obamacare. You know, I've already started overhauling my blood, because I put this at a previous lecture, but I don't like wearing coats. I always build up my blood in the fall. I'm warm. I love keeping myself warm. There's a vegetarian version or the other. You will absolutely enjoy warming up for the winter. Very short term, 6-7 weeks, I'm done for the year. And it's much, how many patients have done this in this crowd? How many people have overhauled their blood with me? A few. I don't get a chance to talk about this much because everybody's so usually messed up. I'm working on other things. And I like to do the fun thing. I try to tell a lot of the patients, get all your diseases out of the way so that you can rebuild your immune system. You can play the brain stuff. Half the pills I take are to make me feel better, not to get me out of disease. I spend most of my time trying to dig these people out of huge holes that they got themselves into up to here, and they can't ever get to the stuff that makes them feel better. They're just trying to bring themselves up to level ground. And some people have made such colossal mistakes, they're never going to be at level ground. Like somebody came up to me, one of my friends. Girls in a room. Dr. Tent, I just turned 50. Should I get a colonoscopy? I said, if you're real proactive, vitamin D, number one, it's all equatorial, vitamin D protected the colon, no chlorine. I want the estrogens and the chemicals out of my body, my detox pathways out. If I don't want to drink any chlorine, I want to digest my food every day. I want to poop every day. You got to go to the bathroom. I want you to keep the vitamin D in the sun. I said, I'm working at that and a number of other things now before. And that was my answer to somebody. But if you have irregular stools, you're passing blood, it's a great test if you need to find something like that in your colon. I grew up with modern medicine, and I, like I said in previous lectures, I fired them at 15, and I'm 53. I have not looked back. Next. I did a lecture, Surviving Winter, a long time ago. You know, it's funny, when I did that lecture, the economy didn't stink. You could actually have a second home. I would not want a second home, Florida or Arizona. I have patients that relocated to Arizona. You know what they come up and tell me? I live in the kidnapping capital of the United States, Phoenix. Phoenix, kidnapping capital of the US. learning to survive winter. I've done everything on that list. I've supported my subclinical thyroid. I've made sure I've gotten plenty of D. I keep my blood healthy, and I'm surrounded by full spectrum lights. It's much easier. I have trouble babysitting one house. I do not want to babysit two, ever. I'm just too lazy. Next. I did that today. I take my Vitanox and my astragalus every day, and I take a half a teaspoon of the IAG in my protein shake every morning. And my immune system's half shot because of pediatric mismanagement. I had the same strep throat till I was 25. So I had the allergy shots and the vaccinations, and he had a field day with me. If I'd hold still, he'd cram something inside of me. And I, at 15, I said, this whole party's been good and fun, but I'm done. Done, never look back. And today, since there's no flu around and all your friends got flu shots, those people are going to be carriers of a strain worse than what's out there. You make these people incubators. You start to incubate things inside these people and let them slough off all this stuff. You're going to slough off stuff for about 20 days in the literature. Picture what pig pen looks like. That's what these people look like that you're coming in contact with. The stores, they're close to you, they're on a bus hacking all over you. And these are not naturally acquired strains. So you better have a strong immune system, because it's going to take out the weak. You're, you know, a third are going to get the shot. They're going to infect the next third. And 30 of you are going to be strong enough not to get it. And I am very aggressive on my immune system, because I do not want to play that collapse game. Next. Now, McCall is asking, they're finding out there's tests on these vaccines that for some odd reason they can cause infertility. Now, who would want to cause infertility? Oh, yeah, Bill. You know, growing up, I have two boys. My son's here with his friends. I have two boys. My wife grew up in a family of girls. So my wife happens to be a female. My mother happens to be a female. I have that old-fashioned family. So for the mothers that come in and that are raising girls today and trying to get them to survive, there's a special piece for people with daughters that I want you to see.
There are questions being asked about the vaccine known as Gardasil. About 8 million American girls have gotten the vaccine, which prevents cervical cancer. But is it safe? Here's Cheryl Atkinson.
The hope is that Gardasil will prove to be a lifesaver, preventing deadly cervical cancer. But today, Merck's HPV vaccine is dealing with a growing number of reports of serious side effects. Jamie Venice passed out and had a seizure after her Gardasil shot.
After my seizure, I remember I didn't want to go to bed because I thought that I wasn't going to be able to wake up.
She was lucky compared to Amanda Ratner. She came down with an illness so excruciating she had to take morphine. Her parents, both doctors, blame Gardasil.
She's gone from the position of being a competitive varsity lacrosse player in high school to somebody who's chronically ill.
Gardasil was approved in 2006 for girls as young as age 9. The conservative-funded public interest group Judicial Watch has obtained more than 8,000 adverse events reports under Freedom of Information law. The reports reveal everything from massive wart outbreaks to seizures and paralysis. Of 18 deaths, nearly a quarter cited blood clots. Jessica Vega got the shot at school when she was 13. Soon after, she was paralyzed. It took a year of braces and treatment to get her on her feet. Brittany Bell was 12. She collapsed with brain inflammation and paralysis. 14-year-old Jenny developed life-threatening paralysis that's resistant to treatment. Merck and the CDC say Gardasil is safe and effective, and that they've not found a link to any deaths. They also say illnesses reported after vaccinations may not have been caused by the shot, and that Gardasil appears safer than most vaccines, with half the average reported serious adverse events. The CDC says it will continue to evaluate the data, while some families are evaluating whether their loved ones should have the vaccine at all. Cheryl Atkinson, CBS News, Washington.
That massive wart outbreak, that might kill the mood a little bit. I don't know. I got an idea. Just say no. Tell your teenage girls. And I think everybody that's old enough to have been past those years, just say no. All right. Yes. What do you think about sticking lithium in the water to settle everybody down? Who do you think could possibly be behind that? Well, it's an organization founded by the notorious Newt Gingrich, the Center for Health Transformation. They're going to transform our health by medicating. They wouldn't medicate our water. Nah, they wouldn't do that. Now, something that I would have had a clip for, but there's only so much I can use. I'm going to tell you something before it happens. They're working on a stress vaccine, and now everybody's going to fall for it. They fell for everything. There's a stress vaccine, and that's in the works right now. And they might be just on the verge. This guy, professor at Stanford, he's right on the verge, and this is CBS News. So his team has pioneered a way to bootstrap a herpes virus to carry engineered neuroprotective genes deep into the brain to neutralize the rogue hormones before they can cause damage. This is on CBS News. You know what this actually means? This is a chemical lobotomy. This is a chemical lobotomy so you won't resist tyranny. This is going to take the part of your brain out that would make you angry for being hosed. Pardon? Well, you know, I don't really know about that, because there's certain things I'm not allowed to question with Mr. Beck, because that makes me a conspiracy theorist, and there's sometimes I like to bring some things up, and he says I'm nuts, and it's very clear that something really wrong is going on. So, you ready for a special story? I promised. I said to Derek, one of the reps was in the back with me. He's got to go because get ready for his family for Europe, and I promised him a special story. Actually, if he caught this before he left. Fear. Special story of how you're raising your kids. Do you live in fear? All day I see people that cower in fear. For example, are you afraid of the Al-Qaeda? See? That's how quiet this is. The Al-Qaeda. How about cholesterol? You afraid of cholesterol? Men shake in my office about cholesterol. They shake. What am I supposed to do? Are you afraid of Whitey? Whitey, that's me. Are you afraid of the Muslims? My son went to Beirut last lecture, my son was in Beirut with the Muslim neighbor. Are you afraid of the blacks? It got quiet. Don't say nothing about the blacks. What about the flu? Are you afraid of the flu? I got a whole list. Anthrax. I watched men duct taping their house shut because they were coming to get them with anthrax. grown men that live in Detroit, afraid. Guns? Do guns scare you? I'm watching people shake about the whooping cough. One kid can die in the Philippines in a toilet, and they'll shake in my office. How about polio? My dad had polio. He's sitting right there. Dad, wake up. Raise your hand. We'll get you some food as soon as you go home. You'll be able to eat. You'll be happy. Tetanus. Because tetanus terrifies people. They've never seen what it looks like in their life, but they're afraid of it. And they've never seen it. Dylan, where were you last week?
Florida.
Doing what?
Racing.
What kind of racing were you doing?
Motocross.
You know, I've seen that supercross racing, all those 100-foot jumps. Those are all his motocross buddies right here. These guys are very good. These guys are ranked nationally. My son was flying through the air with his friend Earl and Trevor. Trevor's going to get a contract. Earl's working on that. Dylan's hoping to get that. And I don't have any insurance.
Earl doesn't either.
Earl doesn't either. How many bones have you broke, Earl?
12.
He's still standing. Trevor, how many bones have you broke?
Two.
Only two. It was a pretty bad one, wasn't it?
One was bad, the other one was just good.
So watch my son get stitches from his motocross, and watch what the nurse tries to scare us about. Tetanus. Since my last lecture, I watched somebody scared to death of a sick person. People ask, am I contagious? Am I contagious, Dr. Tent? I said, I got you hawking and spitting all over me for 30 years. I should have been dead by now. They're drooling all over. The kids are throwing crap all over the room. People are sneezing. And they're flicking socks in my face. My favorite thing is a sock flick in my face. And they want me to look at something on their toe. And as I start to bend over, they flick the sock just like this. And a little cloud of sock dust. Toenail fungus, corn juice, permeates my face. Kelly, Amy, am I making this up? They want, if they don't flick a sock in my face, they're not happy. Since the last lecture, about 2.5 months ago, this is where this is going. I live in Northville. 2.5 months ago, Dylan and my wife went to lunch. It's 1 o'clock on a beautiful summer afternoon. Somebody came in and kicked in my front door and stole our computers, our laptops, went through the house. Stole our iPads. I live in Northville. I live out where Whitey lives. So, I come home. It looked like a smash and grab. They kicked open the door, took my wife's stuff for the office, grabbed some stuff. I went upstairs. Sue, are you using my computer? Cops never went upstairs. My Mac was gone. They took a couple of guns. I opened up Derek's room. The monitor's gone, and his computer. Derek's at CCS right now. He's in his third year. He got a very expensive graphics design computer. They took his monitor, took his computer, grabbed some guns. We did not go upstairs. My wife is so busy with the cops, they dusted the fingerprints and everything and checked everything out. So I come home, go upstairs, they ransacked upstairs. Nobody went upstairs. My stuff is gone. My wife calls Derek at CCS. Derek, somebody stole all your computer stuff, your iPad, your monitor's gone. Derek says, I got an iPad. There's a GPS on my iPad. I'll find it. He whips open his computer. He said, it's in Walled Lake, and it's on the move. Derek comes flying home from CCS at 100 miles an hour, down 96. Larry, you got to give him a pass on this. I have some cops here. They're watching. And so my wife calls the Northville cops and says, hey, my son's got this computer. His computer's on it, GPS. It's in Walled Lake right now, and it's moving. And they said, don't worry about it. We'll look into this tomorrow. So when Derek hauls up in the driveway, he's got this out. We're watching the red dot drive down the street. I grabbed my 357. I grabbed my 380. My wife grabbed her 38. And Dylan grabbed a baseball bat. And off we went to find the dot. It went to an apartment in Walled Lake, and it went to a house. My wife's in her 350 Super Duty twin-turbo diesel truck. I'm in my little CTS, and we take off. Derek was the brains behind the operation. He had his laptop out in his lap, and he's tracking this, and we're hunting this down. We get around 14 mile on M5. I'm not going to say the name of the store. It's all of a sudden, it shuts off at this parking lot. 6 minutes before we got there, the beep. Somebody knew that the iPad was deactivated. So we pull flying into this parking lot of a phone store. I'll let the store stay. And there's the most suspicious guy standing by the door. It was the manager. He was completely guilty. We go flying up into the parking lot, and we're out there. And we're standing there looking to grab somebody and hit them. And there's a van sitting there with tinted windows, and it's idling. And I walked up and looked in this van, and I couldn't see anybody in the van. And Derek goes, it's right there in that van. And Sue says, I'm going to pull my car up behind it. You swing your car around, and we're going to wedge him in. So my wife pulls up the truck behind him. I start to bring my car around, and all of a sudden, 7 cars surround us. We've cornered the undercover cops in Northville. So my wife's going up. She's going to shoot the first one in that car. And this woman jumps out and says, what are you doing? She said, I just got ripped off. I'm looking for my stuff. She said, we're the cops. We're looking for your stuff. To keep the story short, we were ordered to stand down and split. They were on a stakeout for our stuff. The Northville cops were on task for this, unbeknownst to us. So the point of the story is fear. The next day, the uniform cop, I went to work like usual on a Thursday. The uniform cop came back to the house, walked in laughing his head off, and said to my wife, you guys are the baddest family in Northville. They said, we have never, ever seen anybody do this. Do you think I'm afraid of cholesterol? The Al-Qaeda? I'd love to welcome the Al-Qaeda. Come visit us on the plane in Detroit. And I have a message for the people that broke into my house. You forgot a few things. Me and the boys have a special celebration planned for you. Make sure we're there when you come by next time. No, we did not get our stuff back. And I know the manager of that store deactivated that iPod. And if I could have, I'd have shot him. But then I'd had to answer for that, and I don't want to answer for that. Right. Fear. I want you to remember that when you ask me these questions about being scared in the room. Bollywood. They're taking this task on that right now, unbeknownst to the world, there's been 150,000 suicides in India. Since Monsanto sells them expensive seeds that they can't afford, they got to sign their land over, and if they got a bad yield, they lose the farm. Guess how most of them commit suicide? They drink Roundup. They don't have guns. They got to drink Roundup, and that's the commonest form of farmer suicide in India. Next. Some of my special eco-friendly people, your reusable bags are disgusting. They're disgusting. Loma Linda, a famous university, University of Arizona, found all kinds of bacteria in the bags. E. coli, nasty stuff. Now, you know, a very dilute Clorox solution would probably be the most cost effective. I wouldn't use that spray. I'd use the Clorox solution if I wanted to really save the environment, which obviously BP wasn't too concerned about. Kind of interesting, this consultant tried to bring up the fact that he tried to tell him he was an administrator and a consultant. What he found, I was ignored, pressured to change my opinion, and when I refused to do that, I was intimidated and terminated. He tried to say, I think CAT scans are wonderful, but when I see them done on people for growing pains, and the headache that's gone on for like 2 days. Next. If you want to lose your job, talk about something that they don't want you to talk about from the company that you're getting paid for. And he's trying to tell people there's a lot of unwarranted solid organ abdominal cancer, he tried to explain. That cost him his job, and he was paid to tell them what he found. The sheriffs want to know the medication you're taking so that they can keep an eye on you. So in North Carolina, they're trying to get a list of prescriptions. Don't you think we should keep an eye on the doctors that are peddling all this crap? Would that make any sense? And, you know, it's kind of funny to watch Elvis's doctor and some of these guys, Anna Nicole Smith, and I'm amazed. Can you imagine if I would have done that to Michael Jackson? If I would have done this to Michael Jackson? If I would have done this? If I put him on a vitamin and he got that sick? You watch how they cover when Heath Ledger died. He only had 7 medications in his system. They just called it just a mix of medications. It was a simple thing. Don't worry too much. He only had 7 in his system. Only Elvis Presley had 9. He had 9. And he died on the throne, the king. Next. You know, if I wanted to shorten my life, all I'd have to do is eat ice cream every day. I eat so little ice cream, milk makes me sick. I can't digest it. My African Americans can't digest it. Drive down 96 and watch Spike Lee with the milk mustache on the way to Detroit. There's no possible way they can digest it. I can't digest it, ever. And I would die, not only just, I'm allergic to the milk protein. Now, when you get into the engineered bovine growth hormone, Ben and Jerry's is the only company that gets all their milk from dairies that have pledged not to inject their cows with the Monsanto BGH. Canada, New Zealand, Japan, Australia, and all 27 nations of the European Union have banned what's in your milk and ice cream. It causes breast cancer, prostate cancer, and colon cancer. I think I'm colon cancer. Breast cancer, prostate cancer, and colon cancer. Now, Häagen-Dazs, Breyers, and Baskin-Robbins claim their ice cream's all natural with that stuff in it. An engineered growth hormone. You want things to grow, you keep pounding yourself with these engineered growth hormones, you will. That's like, how well can you get the estrogen out of your liver? I've always got to train the patients how to detoxify their body. You got to get the alcohol out. You're going to have to get the estrogen out. You're going to have to get the chlorine out. You're going to have to get all these hormones in the food out. You're going to have to get the antibiotics out. And just when I was sitting there reviewing my notes tonight, I watched them pull Thomas Wellinger went to court. They're still battling with this dude. Now, he took a Librium and an antihistamine. When he was so drunk that he hit that Weinstein family, he blew a 4.3. Larry, have you ever seen a 4.3 on the highway? Not that, 4.3. He didn't touch the brakes when he hit that family of three. He was blind drunk on a Librium and an antihistamine. Has your doctor taught you this stuff? As I'm talking about, if you have this medication, you'll notice the alcohol. You won't notice the pesticides. And I watched a 40-minute clip of a Dr. Gupta in Michael J. Fox Sunday. They interviewed him, and they brought all the Parkinson's specialists on. And I was watching Larry, Moe, and Curly in action. After $200 million, this is what they did. And all the farmers shake in proportion to what states have the most farmers. Why do you think farmers have the most Parkinson's? Because they have the most pesticides. The pesticides make people shake. But $200 million hasn't inched them one closer. I just watched Michael J. Fox. This guy's the golden goose. He is the gold, $200 million. Wow. Next. All the main function of Viagra for the men, this is for the men, and it has a lot of other properties for the women, nitric oxide, NO2. Nitric oxide. I found the cheapest source. Biotics had a pill called Zorax. We're going to call it TK for the sake of the lecture, because the Biotics people hate the name. There's Tomcat for the men, and there's Pussycat for the women. Harry hung his head in shame when I was at a doctor's seminar. He was talking about blood chemistry, and he threw this out. He said, I'm embarrassed to talk about this, so we're going to refer to this as TK. And the PK version's coming out soon. But NO2, all Viagra functions by dilating and relaxing the arteries. 4 a.m, and it works great within a bottle. You stick that with a testosterone modulator, because you poor men have been feminized and estrogenized thoroughly. So I'm a hockey player. I like, again, back to the how much fear is in your system again. Are you afraid? You get enough estrogen in your system, you will squeal like that Deliverance guy. Next. Most people, I hope, did not know what I was talking about. We're going to have a party before that happens, I promise you. Now the federal government is stepping up research into the safety and effectiveness of a wide range of over-the-counter supplements. Garlic, soy, elderberry, licorice, black cohosh, St. John's wort. I took two of those this morning. I take those so I can talk about Lipitor for the 5 millionth time. And I can answer the same question to the same person 1,000 times. I took some licorice this morning. I had a non-genetically modified soy shake today. They want to check this safety and effectiveness. They're really concerned about you, that their government of ours, and you know that. Next. Well, the European Union is gone. As of April 1st, 2011, all medicinal herbs will become illegal in the EU. They got them. Make a centralized authority. The euro is going right down the toilet. The money's gone. Europe's done in April. And you're next. I will guarantee you, you're next.
When's China's turn?
The atmosphere will kill them in China. You can't touch drink, you can't breathe the air, you can't touch the water. China will be sterile in two generations. They're just a little bit behind us, but they'll be as sterile as you guys are next. When I was growing up, you were concerned about fertility. And if you young guy, you guys in your 50s know what I'm talking about, you were scared of fertility. Can you know what I'm saying here? Are you getting that? Some of you women were petrified of fertility. Petrified. There's a lot of times watching that calendar, setting that clock to see what was... Don't look at me like that. You know exactly what I'm talking about. Now, today, they have to buy children because the fertility is, like, gone. What a change in only 30 years. April 1st. I said the antibiotic-resistant infections are going to take more people out than the so-called, quote, AIDS. And I'll touch on that at another subject next year. We'll just use that as a garbage basket term to describe a variety of diseases. 70% of all your antibiotics are in your food. Tens of millions of pounds of drugs each year is used in animal feed. Next. The European Union actually banned the routine use of antibiotics in animal feed years ago because of evidence about its drug resistance. Anybody that goes to Canada will tell you, go to Canada and eat a quarter pounder. It will not taste like ours. It's against the law. They cannot put that stuff in. Go to Europe and we were on a vacation some years back and Derek had a quarter pounder in a mall. And he insisted that we all get one to taste what it tasted like because it was nothing like ours. You're not allowed to put all that stuff in it. Trying to tell people I've not taken antibiotics since I was like 15, knowing that I'm eating them every single day. And when you eat E. coli, and you eat salmonella, and you eat all these things, you know what happens? You know what they call it when your gut really gets disturbed? They call it colitis. They call it irritable bowel syndrome. They call it Crohn's disease. There's 100 names for a disturbed colon. Like you've seen lots of these patients discuss this. There's pre and probiotics. I eat out all the time. I'm getting poisoned constantly. He who's got the healthiest gut germ is going to survive. We're all eating contaminated food. You better get used to it. Your produce is a wreck. That's the stuff, the poop and pee all over. How many times do they say E. coli in the news? 3 times a week? How many recalls has there been? You better have a very healthy gut germ. Walking by the sink, I'll take, now remember, there's a pre and a probiotic. We finally got everything in one spot. I will take a couple of those Dylan came home. Did you have a fun trip home?
No.
No. Why did you not have a fun trip home? What did you do all the way home?
Food poisoning.
It was coming out of both ends of him. What was it? You said you had a magic chicken quesadilla. Is that what it was? Ah, a little poop-soaked quesadilla. Now, my son, at about 7, ate a fast food chicken sandwich. My, remember that? About 10 years ago, 11 years ago. It's right in Northville. He crapped blood and cramps for 3 weeks. He went from 80 pounds down to 69 pounds, lost 11 pounds. He'll never forget this. He would have been told, your son has colitis. It took me 3 weeks to get the crap out of his intestinal tract that wasn't his. Three. He lost weight. My parents were scared. My family was scared. I wasn't, because I do this all the time. It took 3 weeks for me to stop his gut from actually shedding its own lining. To this day, he will not go to that restaurant or that fast food chain. And it was a chicken sandwich that he'll never forget in his entire life. I've seen 5 years of this. I just had one from Maryland today. Maryland. And most 95% of these patients are doing very well, and they're off all their medications and supplements. You got to know how to sterilize the GI tract when you get yourself into something. Is it hot in here? So open, can you open the doors or something? I'm just going to cook everybody. I'm going to cook me. So I want, and this is something I've had to do because I'm disturbed about. Now, I got one of those eggs. I went to the local Italian restaurant, me and my father. I took him about 6 weeks ago. And I had some chicken Alfredo, something that I would eat after work on Friday that I would not eat during the week. I don't want a lot of carbohydrates on work day because I can't stay awake. And you sound more irritating to me if I eat a lot of carbohydrates. I'm a lot more irritated. A bagel, a pancake, I'm going to start glassing over, and I'm not going to pay attention. Just pay attention. I have to have. Today I had a steak chicken combination and a baked potato. Hockey days, I have to have a high protein diet to play hockey. That's just the way it is. I'm wide awake, I'm focused, I'm alert, my moods are stable. I've said it to you 100 times, you can't live on carbohydrates. Why can't my kid concentrate? You gave him cereal and a Pop-Tart. I'd be a lunatic on cereal. This is all day. This is, what did you feed him? Teacher says he can't concentrate. Eat Fruit Loops and a donut. It's food allergies. It's, and the guy said it was his, you know, it was, it just goes on and on. He needed Ritalin. He was hyperactive. He can't live on his crap. It's all candy and sugar. I don't know. I'm telling you, it's a lost cause. Just buckle up and enjoy the ride because we're heading down. Jesus is coming back, though. Amen. Next. The expert in his field said your genetically modified food is killing the rats. Arpad Pusti. Go ahead. Next. Within 10 days, man, they got some weird things. Precancerous cell growth. You don't know anybody with precancerous cell growth, do you? Smaller brains. You don't know anybody with a small brain, do you? I had a guy in yesterday, my new patient. He's not here, so we're going to talk about him. He's got some oddball infection. So he's been to all the doctors. I'm always the last. I'm the last. Always. So he's 59. Let's discuss this guy. He pees all the time. Pees constantly. Well, how long have you been peeing constantly? Well, for 10 years. You're peeing constantly for 10 years. All right. I said, well, what was your diagnosis after $50,000 in tests? He said, my famous urologist said, I have the bladder the size of a 5-year-old. I said, what happened the previous 49 years? I never thought about that. So at the age of 49, your bladder shrunk to the size of a 5-year-old. Geez, that doesn't make sense, does it? No. This is why the Chinese are making your cars now. That's why I had to sit in the room. Now, you're lucky I had my protein yesterday, because I had to restrain myself. The bladder that shrunk to a 5-year-old. That's what $50,000 gets you in a million trips to the bathroom. Livers, and you don't want men, you don't want smaller testicles. They're going to steal your stuff, and you might have to go get it. Good. All right, here we go. Do you realize your mattress has the potential to be an antenna? An antenna. And all the electrical stuff in your room can be magnified by your mattress. The rate of breast cancer in Western countries is 10% higher in the left breast than in the right. This is also true for skin cancer, melanoma. In the US, bed frames and box springs are made of metal, and the length of a bed is exactly half the wavelength of FM and TV transmissions. The maximum strength of the field develops 75 centimeters above the mattress, so when sleeping on your right side, your left side will be exposed to the highest field strength. Next. You know, is today to battle this unseen force that I know is destroying these people, and I can watch how these electrical fields are destroying people. It's very obvious after 30 years of watching unusual symptoms, and you're going to learn stuff today. Next. Earthing or grounding refers to connecting your body directly with the earth. Earth is an electrical planet charged with a subtle surface energy commonly known as what? The ground. There's a reason it was called the ground. When in contact with the earth, this tranquil energy naturally refers to any conductive object. Whether it's a metal rod, a wire, a tree or plant, an animal, or a barefoot human, they become grounded. The Earth's electrical surface is always negative, meaning that the surface is filled with free electrons. They are able to move and reduce a positive charge. Next. The known effect of grounding is that it discharges and prevents the buildup of electrical stress. Now, I've asked some men patients, and I remember the good old days of rebuilding engines and doing auto shops and fixing things. For the 50-year-old men and some of the kids, what did you never do with a car battery? What happened if you put it on the ground? How long? Overnight. You can lose a car battery overnight if you put it on the cement floor. This is how all this stuff started. It's not going to last at all. Your body becomes suffused with negatively charged free electrons abundantly present on the surface of the earth. your body immediately equalizes to the same electrical energy level or potential as the earth. Walking barefoot on the earth, as humans have done throughout history, naturally grounds and discharges the body. When you go on vacation and you wander around on a beach, is it because you wandered around on the beach and you're on vacation, or was it because you grounded yourself for 7 days? The ocean magnifies it. And to learn how to ground yourself today through this winter, how many patients? Now, I have a small group of patients here today that I've actually started this with because I didn't like their blood work. Their platelets stunk. Their white blood cells stunk. They've had myelodysplastic leukemia. You can spot it. Their white count is odd, and it doesn't make any sense. How many people know somebody with leukemia in this crowd? Raise your hands. Leukemias and brain tumors have a lot to do with electrical cancers. The Indians said the shoes were going to kill the white man. So we killed the Indians. That was mean. The most reported benefit from people who placed, this was the most barefoot summer my family has ever had. We basically threw the shoes away outside. Now, for the people, I've had some people professionally earthing. And to kind of make this, I can go talk to these people in the crowd, and it's always kind of a long thing. So I can do it a lot quicker myself. When you've been stored up with a lot of electricity, your body, when you lay down at night, is going to feel vibrating. It's going to feel buzzing. It's going to feel like there's a motor on that you can't shut off. I've had them say, I feel like there's a pager in my head. There's a snowblower going off. I feel like I'm idling. I've had them come in and say this. Something's wrong with me at night. Kelly, where's Pam at? Pam, how much stuff was plugged into your bedroom?
4 cell phones, TV, DVD player, 2 computers, 2 alarm clocks. In the winter, an electric mattress.
So she came in, I'm vibrating and buzzing. She went home, I showed her, which we're going to see in a minute, how to ground your body while you're sleeping. Lou, over, can I have over this away? My mother has been grounding. My parents, I've showed them how to ground through the night. My mom says, Mom, raise your hand. I'll say it for you. Here's my mother. She said, I have never slept like this in my life. I have never slept. Gals.
Like this.
All the way from Grant. These like are the gals that give me out of tickets on the way to West Branch. They live in West Branch. Go for it. What happened when you grounded?
I used to wake up 5-6 times a night, turn the TV on, fall back to sleep. Now I don't turn the TV on at all. I don't wake up. And I don't jump around anymore. All the jiggling in the legs gone.
These people are vibrating, and this gal has dealt with a pre-myelodysplastic leukemia for 25 years. That pre-leukemia blood test. And I showed her 2 cool things. She's going to take certain blood building things and ground herself, and you watch how this, and how long have you guys been doing this?
2 months.
2 months.
And we could go out and build fences on our 40 acres, and we did.
Yes.
We had one pad left, and I took it home for my sister because she's the one with the pre-leukemic. And we put it on her bed, and she started sleeping like a baby. So she says, well, here, you got to try this. So I put it on my bed.
She wouldn't give it back.
I won't give
it back.
We had to buy another one for me.
Now, at the computer industry, people at work, inside. Think about your day. When was the last time you touched the ground? When was the last time you actually had your foot on the ground? You don't. You never do. And you watch what it's like. All summer, I'd go home all tired out from work. I'd take a book in the backyard. It took 45 minutes sitting with my feet on the ground to feel completely, to have all the angst of my legs completely gone. 45 minutes. Electrical current going through your body, buzzing. I can't stay asleep. Next. There's less, I've had patients in 2 weeks say all that buzzing is gone. That vibration, this is a daily discharge you have to get out of your system. This is daily. You can't do it a time, you couldn't spend 5 hours one day and think that tomorrow's another day. I had a patient with leukemia that had the letter house go in Canton because they had 14 Wi-Fi towers going through their house in the subdivision. And Dr. Gonzalez, almost, how many people know who Nick Gonzalez is? He's the cancer doctor in New York. He's my buddy. We've worked with patients for 30 years. He's extremely impressed with this practice. Extremely. He was on Larry King with Suzanne Summers, and he's a high-profile guy. He's on 48 hours and 60 minutes, and he turned down a residency as the chief of oncology at Sloan Kettering to run his clinic a different way. And one of my patients was at his place about a month ago. And he said, does Dr. Tent know about this earthing thing yet? And I said, Diane, that's my lecture at Christmas time. Tell him to keep his mouth shut till after Christmas. So this is going around the cancer clinics because it's simple and cheap. A patient has a low platelet count. I have vibrations in the body. Now, before I draw all this stuff, how many of my patients in this crowd come to me for mechanical problems, back and neck? Everybody raise your hands that I've adjusted in this crowd. Everybody, all of you, I'm going to adjust you on the wrong side if you don't raise your hand. You'll be looking left when you're going right. Okay, I'm going to do something different. Okay, you can put your arms down. How many people have been in the office for heart issues? Raise all your hands if you've been in the office for heart issues. Okay. How many people have been in for chronically compromised? Now, this is the people you talk to. This is live. If you're a neighbor, you can ask them whatever you want. How many people have had immune compromised issues? Raise your hand. How many people have come in for mood issues? Moods, swings, all that kind of stuff. I don't want to be labeled as this to this crowd. That's what I'm trying to do here. All right, next. This really didn't fit. One moment I had this nice executive. Oh, this nice guy, his name's Wallace. The guy, 62 years old, retires. Goes on an expensive safari to Africa. Gets all the travel vaccines for Africa. Comes back 3 weeks later, he's got acute myelogenous leukemia. And his hematologist told him, that's from those travel vaccines. Done. That's from those travel vaccines. That was horrible. You should see what his blood looked like. This kind of got into the lecture, but this is not something an earthing sheet's going to take care of. The known effect of grounding is that it discharges and prevents the buildup of electrical stress. Free radicals have a positive charge. Free radicals have a positive charge. The earth is negative. All the destructive things in your body have a positive charge. That's very important. Animals, paws, everything contacts the earth. Roots. The sole of your foot has 1,300 nerve endings per square inch. All your nerve endings, the highest concentrations in your feet, this is why you had them in your feet. Next. You spend time, your moods will change, your health will change. I've had my parents in the backyard till I got them some devices to use in bed. They were both pleasantly amazed. Because the 70, 80-year-old people, their feet, shoes have never been off. They've never touched the ground. That's just not something they did. As often as possible, expose any of your parts of your skin to the grass, lake, stream, or an ocean. Go swimming or walk barefoot in these waters. Ocean water is even better. Lean up against the trunk of a tree. You can lean up against the trunk of a tree. You can actually get some energy out of nature. Next. Benefits, reduction of inflammation, better sleep, stress. It goes on and on. When you get into this subject and you listen to the case histories of the people, there's so many factors involved with electrical stress. My legs, if you unplugged it one day out of 30, when I got up in the morning, I could tell you if it wasn't plugged in. One day. We were unplugging it and taking it out, unplugging it because they thought the cat was going to chew the cord. There's a little tiny cord. Well, I'll explain that in a second. So we kept taking it in, and we'd get up, take it under the bed. Pretty soon it was obvious the cat wasn't interested in that cord. He wanted to chew on the cable cord. So how did we get the cat to stop chewing on things? Could have killed the cat. This cat found us. We did not go for a cat. This cat hung around the house. He's a Bengal cat. Is there any cat people out there? He looks like a leopard. He's a $1,000 cat if he wasn't fixed. So he's been declawed and fixed, started hanging around the house, and he's one of the most beautiful cats. The vet said, that's a $1,000 cat. We tried to find who his owner was. We couldn't. So we have this cat. He's just incredible. He's an incredibly beautiful cat. So the one day I got up and I had not regenerated my body, and it was very obvious, man, I will not think about my legs when I get up in the morning. If I get up and think about walking, that thing wasn't plugged in. It's very easy to spot. Next. Medical science know that the body is electrical in nature. We talked about free radicals are positively charged molecules at the core of inflammation, tissue destruction, and disease. Electrons move from the earth to the body and vice versa when the body is grounded. This effect is sufficient to maintain the body at the same negative charge electrical potential as the earth. Grounding powerfully reduces EMFs on the body. Next. Wet grass works the best. Wet grass. A concrete basement floor is also a good spot for earthing. If the concrete is painted or sealed, forget it. Asphalt, carpeted concrete, wood, or vinyl surface does not work. This is the one. Now, we have one of these to give. One of these is in the prizes. There's sheets. Now, I'm kind of thinking I'm too cheap for the sheet. This is what we have. This is what the gals have. This is what Pam has. This is what my parents have. It's on Dylan's bed. It's on my bed. And it plugs in. When you look at your, here's your, that hole, that's the ground. So it's got a tiny little cord. You have to have a grounding plug on your electrical outlet. So if you just got old houses, might just have those two. It has to plug in. You don't use those two. It plugs in right to the ground. And it comes with a kit that you plug in, and it tells you if it's grounded. So you have something. This thing. You plug this thing into the thing and it tells you if you have a successful ground. And the plug, which people really can't see, looks like this. And that's that little round thing. And I tell you, working indoors under those ballasts, those fluorescent lights, is a catastrophe. I spend my day. The magnetic discharge off of those is so bad, I did not talk about it at my lectures ever because I thought it would scare my employees. The discharge is that bad. I did not talk about it. It's horrible. And it's the magnetic part that's worse than the electrical part. So you see this now, at night, I'm trying to pull up my pant legs so that I can contact that. It's amazing what it feels like. King and queen. Next. When I go home, you computer workers, if you're going to spend the whole day, I have in my living room, it sits right here, I have a lazy boy chair, and as you can imagine, I don't sit still well. So here's a lazy boy chair, and I have a rocking stool. So when I go home at night to find out all these weird things and to find out, I go home, surf all my websites, I need to find out what freedom did I lose while I was at work today? What have they given away? If I can say this, whose genitals will I be paying to wash today? I go home, sit in my chair, put my feet out. This is my laptop sitting here, and I have that on this plugged into the wall, the little round hole. So that's what my feet are on. And I got my heels. That's bad enough, and there's something I put between here and there that that's another discussion. And that's the two things that I use, those two things. Now this is even more secret. Next. The Tour de France runners and bicyclists, the high-end athletes, they carry this in their backpack and they will not talk about it. Will not. People say, who? You are not gonna. Yeah, professional athletes, they are a very secretive group because I've worked with a ton of them. They're not going to tell the guy in the next room, the guy sharing a room with them, what they're doing. This is a business. You think they're all, we play sports, buddy, buddy, I'm in a hockey team, I'm in a 50-game season. We're in third place out of 14 teams. We're having a blast. We share little things. Sports guys do not talk back and forth. So the elite Tour de France runners sleep in an earthing sack. You can regenerate. If you went outside and slept on the ground, it'd do the same thing. You sleep on the dirt. You could work all day, centuries ago, all day. And you slept on the ground and woke up, your body was completely regenerated. You were ready to go do the same thing the next day. That does exactly the. So there's a sack that they plug in, same thing. The NFL's using that. A lot of NFL. What you have, you watch with these guys get beat around all day. The Lions get beat around all day. You slide yourself into that sack, you are regenerated the next day. It will cut your recovery time, they say 70% from trying to sleep on a bed by itself. I was at a friend of mine was over a Saturday night, Jamie and Bill. He's a truck driver. I said, Bill, there's something really cool for the drivers. I said, I'm going to talk about this at a lecture. You've got to follow this up for truck drivers. Plug it in, ground it. You can get as close to the can. You have to ground it to the frame. So driving for a living, I don't believe it's going to work as good as the earth. But you can ground it to the frame. That's cool. There's my cheesy son. That's my dog's, that's my Pomeranian, that's our dog, and his name is Tesla. And I have to tell the young kids, no, he's not named after the rock band. He was named after the inventor. The cat's name is Edison. We have Edison and Tesla. There's a Q-Link. We covered this in the past, so I'm not going to, this happened to be kind of with that same topic. Now, I had a major CEO in Tuesday, great guy, famous guy, Wall Street's baby. And he had on his, I said, look, I'm doing something cool at the lecture. He comes in from out of state, great guy. Me and my dad have been limoed out to lunch with him and him, and that was a lot of fun, and he's a great guy to work with. I said, I'm doing something cool at the lecture. I'll make sure you get a copy. And he pulled out his cue link, and I mean, he said, I'm still using them. I'm working on this electricity all day. He's dying to hear about this. One of the few guys that thinks outside the box. That's why he's a highly paid executive. He thinks outside the box. Now, Dylan, next, hold up your phone. You got that on your phone?
Yeah.
Hold that up. There's 10 of these, I think, in the presence. See that thing right there? That little round thing at the top of that? That's to kind of keep me from having to pay oncology fees for his brain for how long he's on that thing. All his friends are cell phone addicts. You can stick that thing on your phone. It kind of helps keep you from frying your melon. And that is approved by the powers that be, whatever that means. Next. I think there's 100 in the gift pack. Stick it on your phone. Make sure it's clean. Stick it right on, right the side that you got it next to your ear on. It's going to help keep your head from frying. What's my limit on a cell phone officially? 18 minutes. I've timed it. After 18 minutes, I'm done. I don't care who I'm talking to. It'll cook my head. I feel like I'm cooked that far in my head. 18 minutes, I am absolutely done. Done. I don't care who it is. I got to go. My head's turning into a cookie. I got to go. I can switch back and forth. It's still going to cook the other side. And pretty soon, I feel totally cooked, and I'm completely done. There's one. I think this one is the computer pad. And this one is the one that goes on your bed. There's these presents in addition to all that stuff. All right. There's something for hardcore computer people. You can't get access to this. You can plug that right into your computer port, and that will make a difference on your computer. People feel, my son uses that at CCS. She uses it all the time. Does it make you feel different when you're on it? Then you shouldn't use it. Give it to your husband. I can say that to Phyllis because she's a patient. Next. You know, it's a strange thing. You know, I'm very proactive on this because I don't know. This is very debilitating to the immune system, and it's very slow. And it's debilitating. It's very impressive. It's like the x-rays. How many x-rays till you realize you've had enough? You know how you can tell when you've had enough? They tell you got cancer. Well, now you got cancer. Well, that's when you've had enough. And you didn't feel one of them. This. Next. Anybody been through the airport in the last week over Holly? Was it anybody have an interesting time at the airport lately? Anybody? Interesting?
I went through this last week.
How was it?
And, actually, it wasn't that bad. Went through the scanner, and then Linda was there. She went through the pat down and all that. So it wasn't as bad as it looked like in the on the TV rolls and things like that.
They sounded like they really, a lot of talk show people. Now, you guys got to keep the ball rolling. A lot of talk show people have really been impressed that even the people that aren't paying attention are disturbed this time. Everybody seems to be pleasantly impressed that the masses have kind of woken up. They're hoping that eventually there's going to be a line in the sand that the people are going to start to... Me and Dylan set the stage last winter in Utah, didn't we? Everybody went through the scanner. Did we go through the scanner?
No.
No. We got the
VIP treatment.
We got the back of the hand pat down. They have since turned their hands around for the full pat down. We had that guy all irritated because, remember, what are you afraid of? Tell me what your fear is. We told him, and there's a little sign, we're not going through it. I've talked about this before. He wasn't happy with us. Go get the gloves. I'm standing here till you get the gloves. We had
the gloves over and over again.
Yeah, I know. Get a clean pair of gloves. So, next. Now, I want you all to pay attention to this. I know that there's 15 people in here that know this, and there's hundreds that don't.
Mr. Speaker, a nationwide revolt is developing over the body scanners at the airports, and it should. Hundreds of thousands of frequent flyers who fly each week are upset about getting these frequent doses of radiation. Parents are upset about being forced to have their children radiated or being touched inappropriately by an unrelated adult. There is already plenty of security at the airport, but now we are going to spend up to $300 million to install 1,000 scanners. This is much more about money than it is about security. The former Secretary of Homeland Security, Michael Chertoff, represents Rapiscan, the company which is selling these scanners to his former department. Far too many federal contracts are sweetheart insider deals. Companies hire former high-ranking federal officials and then magically, those companies get hugely profitable federal contracts. The American people should not have to choose between having full body radiation or a very embarrassing, intrusive pat-down every time they fly as if they were criminals. We need a little more balance and common sense on this.
The head of Homeland Security represents the company. Is that what he just said? Michael Chertoff represents the company. So, since I hope that you can laugh at something that came about because of this. My son and his friends were going to Florida. And I started saying something that I shouldn't have said, and it kind of came, one thing led to the other, and another thing led to the other. And I was hoping he wouldn't. I don't know, I think he was too sick to say this, but we were having kind of a laugh, and I hope you will laugh along with this, because we kind of came up with Dr. Tent's top 10 things to make friends with the TSA. Number 10. Be careful, I have a rash down there. Number 9, my camp counselor got arrested for this. Number 8, you really must have set your sights low on career day. Number 7, this is better than spin the bottle. Number 6, you jumped right to third base. You jumped right to third base, soldier. Number 5, this is why we quit visiting the in-laws in West Virginia. Number 4, it used to cost dinner and drinks for this. Number 3, where's my lollipop? The guy at the end of the street always gave me one for this. You're gonna make friends if you throw these out, I promise you. Number 2, is this really what you thought you'd be doing the rest of your life? I think the number 1 thing to say is, watch out, I took Viagra an hour ago. This all started watching these people. Next, I'm almost done. You can get all your stuff. Now, this is important. You guys aren't going to understand this. Hans Niebuhr was a famous doctor in Germany. He had a very special magnesium. It was a magnesium orotate. This. Recover, I want to go over this quickly. Recover from heart attacks and heart surgery, renal failure from diabetes or hypertension, everybody with high blood pressure, everybody that's had a heart attack, all cardiovascular disease, blood clots, MS, cholesterol, atherosclerosis, and athletic performance. And the reason biotics had a ton of trouble getting this in this country, because they wanted to make this a prescription. You sit and watch the things they want to make prescriptions for because they work too good. What did they do? What's that Lovenza, that new fish oil that costs an arm and a leg now, that is not even as, I think, as high a quality as some of the private companies that do that? That is a huge magnesium, and what they had to go through to get that, because it works like a drug. So all those conditions would be immense. That's 600 milligrams, and it's a very high dose, and it's huge for a lot of very specific diseases. The top three deficiencies, zinc, magnesium, and thiamine, are what you're going to hear the companies talk about. There's your Cataplex B, there's your magnesium, and zinc, we'll get to that, I'm sure, at another lecture. And there's a bunch, I don't know how many of those magnesiums in the sack? Six? There's six of those. Learn to use that, it's huge. It's the most potent, powerful, bioavailable magnesium you can get. And anybody that knows the Hans Niebuhr formula, that's that. I'm having lots of people with digestive issues, particularly the fruits and vegetables. This is going to steer towards the fruit. Did we have these in? Six. And this is, people's digestion stinks today. You better digest this mess that we're eating. I'm very fussy to keep my digestion going, because it's all crap. It's genetically modified. You go to a restaurant and get chips and salsa. I'll guarantee you, you're going to get genetically modified chips that's Roundup ready. The pesticides engrafted into the gene. You better digest this stuff, and you better do it well. Next, for those dairy people, I've always liked my SP Complete in the morning. I'll either take that, my shake in the morning, is two tablespoons of that, or the regular, the whey, or the dairy-free one. I don't care. Just give me either one. I take a scoop of the nitro greens. I take two tablespoons of raw chocolate, and I throw that IAG in. Every single morning, it's the same. And I'm awake all morning, and I cannot start my day off wrong. I have to be awake when I walk into work at 8 o'clock. I got to go home tonight. I'm going to be getting out of here shortly, and I got to go in, and I have 11 hours tomorrow, and I'm going to probably have a half hour for lunch. And you should see the stuff I'm going to have to listen to. You would. I'm counting down the days, the hours, till the first sock flick. That's what I want. How many of those? The Syra. Oh, that's first. Sorry. You know, that's a pregnancy protocol. You want to start. Amy has 2.5. Kelly has 1. My staff has been very attentive to their prenatal supplements. And what I do for a pregnant woman is what you all want to do, because that's the highest support that you can get. My prenatal stuff is huge. You want to correct the genetic defects that are being passed along in the family. Okay, there's 5 of those, right? And the next one, 5 of those. These things are kind of, we have a lot of patients that enjoy detoxing. A lot of those. Might buy Michigan's next, isn't it? Long. There's a slide that Kelly's going to go through. Buy Michigan-made gifts for Christmas. They say to restart the economy, spend half your money within 50 miles of your house. Myers is a Michigan company. And I want to say, Farmers Insurance did a fantastic job paying us for our stuff. They were absolutely no problem. The Northville cops did their best. They know not. They drive around our house now. We scared the Northville cops. They still, if you know any of them, feel free to ask. It's gone all over town. Do not mess with the tents. They're not afraid. I want to say support the less fortunate. This is a Christmas. Don't buy me anything. I want everybody to help somebody less fortunate. And if you're the less fortunate one, just wait for stuff. I want to thank everybody. And when this thing's over, I'm going to get out of here and turn this over to Lou. And he's going to tell you what you've won and how to get it. And you guys can fight for the stuff. And have a good Christmas.